Hello everyone, I'm Nini FC from Blue Lions TV. I'm bringing you guys an opposition analysis for the game against Man United on Saturday. I'm joined today by Flex. How you doing, man?
Hey,
you good?
Man, thank you for having me, man. You guys, we've been needing to do this for a while,
100%,
man.
100%, it's been a while. Obviously, you plug your channel. You should know by now, you guys.
United stand, man. Check me out, man. Check us out.
Exactly. But basically, you know, opposition analysis, it's a chance for you guys to understand the opposition team tactically, how they play, how they like to do things. Now, again, you know, this game's going to be interesting. Mourinho, I mean, we've kind of seen how Mourinho has been with us before at Chelsea. But from a tactical standpoint, when it comes to United, what's like one major weakness that you see that really just...
Why are you asking me to pick
nerves?
One? I can't pick both.
Start with the first one.
Do you know what it is? You're talking about tactics, yeah? What tactics? The problem the problem is we have none. The problem is it's just...
Yeah, we've seen it.
What he's doing, like every attack, right, is a freestyle.
Yeah.
There's no sustained pattern of play. Like, it's so embarrassing, right? I'll be honest, because we go to teams like when we got spanked by West Ham, when we got beat by Brighton, even them little smaller teams, even when we beat Watford, but even when we played them, all these lesser teams, there's a way that they're playing. I can see it. It's like with Brighton, for example, it was, right, I'll tell you what, as soon as we get the ball, we'll get it wide to Knockhart, right, then we'll feed it into Glenn Murray, we'll make him hold it up, and then we'll get up the pitch. Exactly. There's a way of playing, you know? We don't have it. Like, I'm looking at our players consistently, not knowing where to go, being hesitant, turning back, going sideways, and that only stems from what you're working on the training ground. It's as simple as that, man.
100%, and it's like, it's kind of funny because it brings up that point where a lot of fans like to make the distinction that, maybe the players aren't good enough for this football, which is, that's the same criticism a lot of
Pogba's,
Chelsea players.
Yeah, Pogba's too good to be playing defensive football, crap football, man.
You know, I was watching games against, like Leicester, for example. I'm seeing Pogba is the one that's got to be defending against Ndidi and Silva. They're good players, actually, in Silva and Ndidi, but Pogba's on another level. How is this guy playing without the ball against these guys?
Because we're not set up right. We're not set up in a way that is that will help.
Yeah.
Add to our attacking players and complement them, should I say? Yeah. That's the word I'm looking for.
Exactly.
We don't have a system that brings out the best in any of our attacking players.
Yeah.
Lukaku's got his flaws. He can't hold up the ball well and he can't link play.
Yeah.
But even to him, we don't even play to his strengths, which is getting him turned and getting him in the channels and running at players.
That's his game.
We don't. Like, at Everton, people keep sending me videos when he was at Everton and all that. Yeah, but we don't play like that.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? We don't. When he's at Belgium, sometimes he gets it in a lot of better positions than he does at us. We don't whip crosses in early. We don't have wingers who beat men and cross.
Yeah.
We don't have fullbacks who do that.
I mean, these things, you know, these things that worked on in the training ground, and you know, I was always making that same point too. Look at certain teams. What's like that typical goal a Man City or Liverpool or Chelsea are going to score? And I was making that point. Okay, what's the typical goal that Man United score?
Don't know.
There's none.
Don't know. Like that, we rely on individual moments of brilliance to score goals. Now, don't get me wrong. I know there will be people out there saying, "Well, would you spend 90 million on Pogba for? Why is Alexis probably the highest paid?"
Yeah.
Yes, of course, they should have individual moments of magic. But the problem is, if you rely on that and that only, you can't have a 38 game season relying on Sanchez trying to put
it's
it.
Not it's sustainable. Not sustainable, and it's like, you know, certain times, let's say, you know, within a context of a certain season, yeah, you might profit once. But don't expect to profit the next season and the season after. It's not long term. And I think that, that's always been the major criticism of Mourinho. It was at Chelsea, everything was improvised. It's always about caring about, okay, this is how we're going to defend off the ball. When it came to breaking teams down, what was it?
And no one knows where to go.
Exactly.
No one knows
and Mourinho's thing's always been, you know, I need top players, I need world-class players. But then that's always the excuse to mask the flaws.
Mourinho.
You know what I mean? Coming to the game tomorrow.
Yeah.
Obviously, you've seen Chelsea and how we play. What type of... Do you think there's any advantages you guys have tactically, or do you think there's any areas you could exploit from Chelsea?
The only advantage we could have, is that you underestimate us.
That's the
And be too much in the comfort zone, thinking, do you know what, this will be an easy game because Man United are in a poor run of form, which we are. They don't know whether their manager's coming or going, which we don't. Like I was saying to 100% Chelsea guys, there's everything to suggest in this game that we'll lose.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Everything. But it's just football, Premier League football at that. And
yeah.
I haven't seen a lot of evidence to suggest we're going to win the game. I haven't. But you never know. And I think that your biggest enemy would be your own complacency. Because, like I said, with the way you're playing football now and the way we're playing, if you turn up, you should beat us.
Yeah.
You should. Fair point. Do you know what I mean?
I do think it's kind of funny, though, that obviously, like, you're kind of relying on the hope in a way, because I was asking, like, what type of areas you guys could exploit, maybe tactically. Like, remember them years back when he sprung Herrera?
Yeah, tried to do a lot of sense, yeah.
Because how you're playing so rigid
difficult
under Conte.
Now, I heard that Matic and Fellaini are now injured, which would force him to maybe play McTominay, which I don't want to see.
And I really think, you know,
I don't know
to really beat teams like Chelsea, I mean, there's only two things I see, you know, luck, or you've got to play football against us and show that
right now, don't get me wrong, I hope I'm wrong, and I hope that we see the Man United that we want to see that can, you know, Alexis coming in and making try playing in the central area, which we're not going to see because Lukaku's going to start.
Oh, exactly.
Start Martial, getting that Azpilicueta, hopefully, you know what I mean? But I just can't see that. I haven't seen enough evidence of recent form to suggest that that would suddenly going to turn up and play that. I can't see
it. And to be honest, you know, people talking about maybe Herrera potentially man-marking Hazard again, it's not going to work
this time.
You know
why
it's not going to work? Because with Chelsea now, the amount of players we have in the final third, we've got guys in the half spaces, which we never had before. It used to be Hazard by himself. It doesn't make sense to man-mark Hazard.
You're sick, man. And you've got Regina on the ball. He just picks a pass. He's making things happen. Barkley stepped a hell of a lot. I've been really impressed with him.
Let me ask you this, actually. Because we've got to wrap this up pretty soon.
Yeah.
Now, I think anytime I do, like, you know, previews on opposition, I always like to, like, see how, let's say, United played against Man City. Because I'm thinking, in terms of the football we play, it's more similar to Man City than it is to, like, Stoke. You know what I mean?
Yeah, of course.
Now, you guys obviously got that famous, I wouldn't say famous, it was a very memorable win against City last season, 3-2.
Again, because his back's against the wall, had to throw everything in the kitchen sink. I call it unorganised, organised chaos. That's what it is.
That's a good way. That's
what it is, bro.
Now, do you think that you guys could potentially, like, try and harken that energy back from that game against us? Because you saw that when
Ringo's
desperate, things can't
happen. Do you know what? No, because now the dust has settled with the international break.
Yeah.
And two, even on a good day, our record is not good here.
Yeah.
We have to not forget that.
Yeah,
we can't forget that. That to try and come here and play you off the park, we'll lose.
Yeah.
We'll lose.
Exactly.
We will.
You're not trained to play
like that. Exactly. Yeah. We can't just try and turn it on for a game. Like if you go Anfield, you can't try and play Liverpool off the park.
Of course.
So I don't, and this is Mourinho, I don't expect him to even try and do that. And it's not even the right thing to do.
Yeah.
We have to have a game plan. Play counter-attacking football, not park the bus football.
Yeah.
The big difference between counter-attacking and park the bus. Park the bus is showing no attacking intent, not trying to score, not trying to transition from defence into attack. Whereas counter-attacking is you're putting players in areas of chance and gamble.
You keep that mid-block when you're trying to
there you go. So that when you do win it, you've got the outlet and you can get forward in numbers.
Okay. Who do you think could be your outlet on the counter-attacking?
Well,
do you think it's going to be? Because let's be serious. Do you think it's a chance for Laney? Will be playing in this game.
Do you know what? I would actually have started him.
I don't know.
I would actually have started him.
Fellaini, I think it really forces the entire play to be one-dimensional.
100%.
I think it ends up affecting you guys a lot.
It does. But if you play the quick players around him and use Fellaini in terms of bringing the ball down and then playing off him, we've done that plenty of times before.
Yeah.
If you use Fellaini right, I've been his biggest critic because when he's trying to be a ball playing midfielder, awful. Like Jose's trying to make him... Jose's trying to make him that guy, and that's where he's falling short. But if you play him like the more advanced in a midfield, just off the front, inside maybe the left channel or just off the front, bringing got the best one of the best chests in football, if not the.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean? He can bring the ball down and you can play off of him.
Yeah,
that can cause people trouble. With the way you're playing, and you could just bypass our midfield easily with him
that's
in there.
That's what I mean. And I think with Chelsea now,
I think he's injured, so we'll be forced to play some people with some legs. So I think it will actually be Herrera, Pogba. And because it's Mourinho, I think it's going to be McTominay, man.
You think it's going to go
I hope not. I hope it's Herrera, Fred and
McTominay
Pogba.
That people really hate.
Do you know what?
I've seen a lot of young players play under Mourinho.
Yeah.
But there's this thing that he likes to instill in young players where it's like you're constantly forced to play your game safe.
Simple. Well, there's nothing wrong with simplicity because that is the beauty of the game to a lot of like Pirlo was, you know, simplicity. But he just likes players who are just basic and don't take risks. Like the thing is with McTominay,
follow instructions
and just does what. Yeah. Like I knew the writing was on the wall when Mourinho was like, Scott McTominay, top kid, doesn't have fancy haircut, does what I ask.
Yeah.
You know, he likes that kind of player, and he's 6 foot plus.
Yeah.
And he's just basic. But the thing is, like, you don't want as a fan, you don't want to slate, especially someone who's coming up out of the out of the academy.
It's not that
he doesn't get slated.
Yeah.
It's the people he's playing ahead of me.
But if you deep it,
come on.
When have you You know, I mean,
sorry.
McTominay in the youth teams for you guys. We're going on a,
he's
a
not,
bit
he's
of a
not
tangent.
Even the most.
What was
he's
he like?
That's the thing.
What was his game?
He wasn't even tipped as the next person to come through. We've got Taif Chong, we've got Andre Gomes, we've got Toon Zabi gone out on loan.
So was that like for Rashford too? Like, he wasn't really seen as one of the big guys
right,
to take it.
But,
the
thing is, Callum when he came in, the difference is though, he proved it though.
But he was
he came in, he was thrusted in, he came with goals, like Van Gaal played him, and then he proved that, you know what, he can live at this level.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not saying McTominay's been absolutely useless, but some of the positions he's been using is terrible.
Yeah.
And for me, I just don't see what his X factor is. Like, he'll keep the ball, maybe go sideways. He does what Matic Fellaini does. Like,
keeps position.
Doesn't matter.
It.
He's just a younger version of them.
But yeah, exactly. I mean, those type of midfield players have a use, but they have to complement the other midfielders. You know, if you've got too many.
He doesn't do that.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's still harsh because I still think, you know, I mean, you know, a lot of players have said it. I mean, Ryan Bertrand said it famously himself. Never he was playing for Chelsea, he could never really play his game because he felt that was a constant audition because he didn't really have that support. But it's like, okay, let's say I have one bad game, I'm still going to be in the team. I'm not going to be completely ostracized. It's a hard environment for McTominay to even want to express himself to show what he can do.
It is, but you know what? He's got the backing of the manager. He got Young Player of the Year last year.
Yeah, but like backing for Mourinho doesn't really count as much, let's be serious.
Well, I think to him it probably would, but yeah, you're right, in the bigger scale of things. But don't get me wrong, no one's booing him or saying, oh, what are you doing?
That's which is different.
Do you know what I mean? It's like, why is he playing instead of Fred? Why is he playing instead of Pereira? Why is Pereira not even in the squad? Why is he playing centre-half instead of Bailly?
Just to wrap up the final point, how do you see the game ending on Saturday? Do you think United have a chance? What are you relying on? Are you hoping Lady Luck's going to be with you guys?
I'm hoping Lady Luck's going to be with us. Like I said to you earlier, we need you to be a little bit complacent, a little bit too cocky, a little bit too, we've got this.
Yeah.
We need a little bit of that. Because, like I said, there's not enough evidence. As much as I want to try and be on the side of optimism, I haven't seen enough evidence recently of anything to go off to say that we're going to come here and blitz you and blow you out of the water from out the blue. Saying that, like I said, with the 100% Chelsea guys, I struggle like coming on and saying that my team's going to 100% lose.
You can't do that as a fan.
Do you know what I mean? There's always, and when it comes to game, I'm going to be right up for it thinking, come on, this could be the game. Like, we all do that as fans. So I'm going to go over a draw.
Okay.
Probably stupidly, I'm going to go over one all draw. Do I truly believe that? I'm not going to answer that question, but yeah, exactly.
You guys, for me, you want to hear my score prediction in my match preview. That's going to wrap up today's opposition analysis video. Flex, obviously, you got to plug all your stuff, bro.
United Stand, get at us. Make sure you follow, like, and subscribe. Well, yeah, rival fans, I know that, but we do a lot of good stuff. Thanks for having us on. Follow me on all the socials, FlexUTD on Twitter and Instagram.
Cool, you guys. And obviously, shout out to Harrison for recording. Obviously,
man like Harrison.
Big man,
man like H.
That, professional and that.
Man like H.
Exactly, exactly. But you guys, that's going to wrap things up. Thank you for watching. I'm Nini FC. This is Blue Lions TV. Signing out.